I don't believe in fairy tales. I guess I've outgrown them. But that doesn't mean that I don't believe that there's something bigger than me. 'Cause I've seen it in a hospital room when the doctor said sorry. There's nothing more we can do. Well, it wasn't through. I've never seen a pot of gold at the end of the rainbow. But I've got a promise I can hold in the middle of the struggle. God, if you said it, you'll perform it. May not be how I want you to, but here's what I'll do. I'm gonna wait on you. I'm gonna wait on you. I've tasted your goodness. I'm trusting your promise. I'm gonna wait on you. Yes, I'm gonna wait on you. Yeah. I've tasted your goodness. I'm trusting your promise. I'm gonna wait on you. Every step, yeah, you are the author, but there's no predicting what is next. But you hold the future, and all the questions, they come second to the one I know is true, yeah. Well, you've always been true, so I'm gonna wait on you.
I know he will. Some self-proclaim they're the GOAT. History provides that my God's the one. No losses, he's won the most. Undefeated champion, be seated on your throne. Ruler, redeemer, savior of the world. Who else could take the sting of death as a man? Resist temptation like mine. You've proven your power and showed us the way, so we could win every time. Undefeated champion, be seated on your throne. Ruler, redeemer, so rise up, champion, we're victorious. Who is greater than? Nothing can defeat our God. Rise up, champion, we're victorious. Who is greater? Nothing can defeat our God. We're victorious.
one accord in one place. And suddenly there came a sound from heaven as of a rushing mighty wind, and it filled the whole house where they were sitting. Verse 4, and they were all filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak with other tongues as the Spirit gave them utterance. Just like he did it before. How many know we need him to do it again? All right, here we go. Just like you did it before, Lord, we are ready for more. Just like you did it before, Lord, we are ready for more. Just like
you did it before,
Lord, we
are ready for more.
Just like
you did it before,
Lord, we
are ready for more.
Just like
you did it before,
on Pentecost,
Lord, we are ready for more.
Just like
you did it before,
in the upper room,
Lord, we are ready for more.
Lord, we
are ready for more.
Tonight,
Lord, we are ready for more.
Right now,
Lord, we are ready for more.
Baptize us in the Holy Ghost.
Lord, we are ready for more.
You know what happened?
Lord, this is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. My soul shall make her boast in the Lord, and the humble shall hear thereof and be glad. Oh, magnify the Lord with me, and let us bless his name together this morning. Praise God. Good morning, and welcome to Kingdom Word Ministry, where we preach and teach the Word of God chapter by chapter, verse by verse. Praise God. I'm excited this morning. Praise God. We're in this season. Praise God. We're in this time of year. Praise God. That we celebrate God's birthday. Praise God. I'm excited. Amen. Praise God. So let's get right into the Word. The Word will be coming from Psalm chapter 1, Psalms 102, verse 12 through 14. Psalms 102, verse 12 through 14, beginning with verse 12. But thou, O Lord, shall endure forever, and thou rememberest unto all generations. Thou shalt arise and have mercy upon Zion, for the time to favor her, yea, the set time, is come. For thy servant take pleasure in her stones, and favor the dust thereof. Praise the Lord. Let us pray. Father God, we thank you for another day, another opportunity to lift you up and to magnify your name. God, I pray this evening, God, that this morning, God, that you would have your way, God. You have your way with me, have your way with your listeners, God. Give them that spiritual ear to hear, because you said, those that have an ear to hear, let them hear. We are sure that this word falls on good ground, it will come up again. So let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be accepted in our sight. O Lord, my strength and my redeemer, and the body of believers shout it, amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. This morning, I'd like to talk to you from the subject, a set time. A set time. This song is a very important song. This song is inspired. The writer of this song is a prayer of affliction. When he is overwhelmed and pouring out his heart in complaint before the Lord. In verse 1 of our text, he says, hear my prayer, O Lord, and let my cry come unto thee. Jehovah, hear my prayer, O Lord, and let my cry come unto thee. Here's a case where Jehovah prays to Jehovah. He came in humiliation, yet he was Jehovah manifested in the flesh. He was God manifested in the flesh. So he was praying for a promise. Praise the Lord. God has a set time to fulfill his promise. See, there's a time for God to show favor towards his people. There's a set time for his return. There's a set time for your deliverance. There's a set time for your blessing. And there's a set time for you to receive your blessing. There is a fixed time that the Lord will cause things to happen or let it happen, praise God. We are at the moment, praise God, of this week coming up, praise God. Hallelujah, that's just passed, praise God. We're coming up, praise God, to December the 17th, praise God. And this
is will be our 15th church anniversary, praise God. And I'm excited about the Lord have kept us 15 years in the fullness of his time. We are here, praise God. And we thank God for another year. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Exodus 3:1 says, to everything there is a season and a time to every purpose under heaven. Things happen in a season that will not happen in other seasons. There's a time for every activity or every purpose under heaven. There is a season. There is a season for you. There's a season for me. Things that happen in this season might not happen for you. Things that happen for me in this season might not happen for you, praise God. Hallelujah. But there is a season. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Verse 2 says, there's a time to be born, a time to die, a time to plant, a time to pluck up that which is planted. Every second, there's a person born, praise God. Every second, there's a person dying. God has a season. God has a set time, praise God. For you, he has a set time. For me, he has a set time for everything that we face in life to happen. Can we say hallelujah? Here we say glory to God. He said, there's a season to plant. There's a time to be planting what God has laid on your heart, your desire, your dream, your aberration. And it's a time to plant that, praise God. And there's a sign, there's a time to harvest that you have planted, praise God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Solomon tells us that it is God's plan for all people. He has a set time. Hallelujah. Glory to God. He provides cycles of life, each of them for us to do our work in, praise God. Although, praise God, we might face many problems that seem to contradict God's plan, but it shouldn't stop us from believing in him, but rather opportunity to discover that without God, problems have no lasting resolution, praise God. Solution, praise God. Hallelujah. Glory to his name. See, there's a time. Timing is important, praise God. All the experience listed in from verse 1 to verse 8 are appropriate for a certain time. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Can we say, God has a certain time. And God has a certain time for what you're going through. He says there's a certain time in every one of these verses, praise God. God has that time for us to work. God has that time for us to sit down. God has that time for us to sleep. Praise God. The secret to peace with God is discovering and accepting his appreciative and appropriate God, perfect timing, praise God. God has a perfect timing. He might not come when you want to, praise God, but he's always on time. Can we say thank the Lord? Can we say hallelujah? God has the perfect time for your blessing. God has a perfect time for your blessing. He has a perfect time for your uprising. He has a perfect time for your downsetting, praise God. He knows what time it is this morning, praise God. God controls the time. God's timing cannot be changed by anyone but God. I'm reminded in Isaiah 38:5, it talks about Hezekiah. Hezekiah was set to die. But God gave him 15 more years. He said, there's a set time for you now. I'm giving you 15 more years. You prayed to me, praise God. And I heard your prayer, praise God, hallelujah. And I'm going to give you 15 more. Can we say, thank the Lord. Nobody can do this but the Lord. Can we say, hallelujah. Can we say, thank the Lord. There is a set time. When we set our alarm clock at a certain time in the morning, when the alarm goes off, we change our attitude, our mind focus, and we move forward. We don't go back to bed and miss the opportunity. We go forward to the challenge that is set before us, praise God. Most of us have our clothes already laid out for that day, praise God. And all we have to do is put them on because we want to be ready, praise God. We want to be prepared for what God has us to do, praise God. We already ready to meet our blessing, praise God. When the alarm clock goes off, we are prepared. Preparation, my brothers and sisters, this morning is important. Preparation is so important that God wanted to stress this thing. See, we set our clock, our alarm to go off on our oven at a certain time. And we wanted to reach a temperature at this certain time that we have our bread already prepared, already ready to put it into the oven, because we have a set time and we don't want to wait after the alarm goes off to prepare. We need to prepare for the alarm goes off, praise God. We need to be ready, praise God, hallelujah. You don't want to wait until the alarm goes off to get ready. You need to be ready, praise God. Look at somebody this morning to be ready. You got to be ready this morning, praise God, hallelujah. The scripture tells us in Psalm 102:13, it said, thou shalt arise and have mercy upon Zion, for the time to favor her, yea, the set time is come. See, there's a law of manifestation. There's a law that a set time, there is a set time, there is a due season, praise God, hallelujah. How many know there's a due season? God has a due season for you. The wisdom of due season lies in understanding that due season always comes. Can we say hallelujah? Can we say glory to God? We look at Galatians 6:9, looking from the NLT version. He says, so let not get tired of doing what is good. At just the right time, we will reap a harvest, a blessing, if we don't give up, praise God. Don't give up. Right at the time you think you're ready to give up, God is knocking at your door and he's ready to bless you, praise God. Due season always come because it is a law, praise God. It's God's word. Don't spend time worrying about whether God's word will come to pass in your life. Instead, spend time preparing for the promise. The word of God must come to law, praise God. It must come to pass because it is a law, praise God. If God said it, that settles it, praise God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. It's God's law. Meanwhile, if you're not prepared, when the word of God shows up, you will miss the promise, praise God. Focus on the preparation for yourself and the manifestation of the promise will take place. Praise God. Hallelujah. There's a set time for God to show favor to his people. There's a set time for your blessing this morning. Praise God. Hallelujah. You've been crying for your blessing. God said, I got a set time for you. Praise God. It's coming when you least expect it. Praise God. Because your mind is not on the world. Your mind is not on the blessing, but on the promise of God. You're on the word of God. Praise God. Hallelujah. Glory to your name. He said, don't get caught getting prepared. Be prepared. Time for God to show favor is come, is here, praise God. It's right here, praise God. Don't be like, Jesus said, don't be like the 10 virgins, praise God, in Matthew 25:1 said, then shall the kingdom of heaven be like unto 10 virgins, which took their lamb and went forth to meet the bridegroom. Jesus is explaining here and talking about what the kingdom of heaven is like. And not only what the kingdom of heaven is like, you need to be prepared because one day, praise God, he's coming back. Can we say hallelujah? Can we say glory to God? The Bible tells us that they all started out. They all went forth to meet the bridegroom. They all had a zeal. They started out, but some of them lost our zeal. When we first get saved, when we first confess God, there's a zeal in our life where you want to tell everybody about God. You want to go around the house and around the world telling people about Jesus, praise God. But if you don't keep praying and fasting and talking to the Lord, you lose that zeal, praise God, hallelujah. The Bible says some of them believed that the bridegroom was coming. They went prepared. Some did not. The Bible tells us in verse 2, he said, and five of them were wise, and five was foolish. They that was foolish took their lamp and took no oil with them. It's like having a gun and going into a gunfight and you have no bullets. Or you gonna say, wait until I load my gun and then we start shooting. You got to be ready. You got to be prepared. Praise God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Can we say thank the Lord? It's about being prepared. Verse 4 said, but the wise to oil in the lamp, and the vessel with their lamp, praise God. The wise to oil in the vessel, their gun was loaded, they was ready, praise God. They was right there to be ready when Jesus come back. He was right there to be ready when the bridegroom show up, praise God. They was prepared, praise God, hallelujah. And look here in verse 5, he said, while the bridegroom tarries, sometimes you know, your situation might tarry. It might tarry a little longer than you expected. He said, the bridegroom tarried. They slept. They all slept and slumbered, praise God. It's all right, my brothers and sisters, this morning to sleep. It's all right to rest, because rest is a weapon. It's a time to sleep. Before you go to bed, though, you need to be prepared for what might happen during the night, praise God. You got to be ready, praise God, hallelujah, glory to God. The Bible said in verse 6, it said, at midnight, there was a cry made, behold, the bridegroom coming, go out to meet him. Things happen, my brothers and sisters, when you sleep. Back in the day, most people was in the bed at midnight, praise God. But things have changed today, things have changed. People are going out at midnight, praise God. They are going out and partying. Some of them are going out even working at midnight, praise God. Hallelujah. But you got to be ready no matter what. You got to be ready, whatever your midnight might be, whatever your situation might be. When you close your eyes, you got to be ready, praise God, because you don't know when he's coming back, praise God. Give us the hallelujah. Verse 7 said, then all the virgins arose and trimmed their lamb. All the virgins got up, praise God. They all was trimmed their lamb. Trimming your lamb was important, praise God. Trimming your lamb would determine your life. He would determine how much light you would have and how long your light would last and how much it would smoke, praise God. The Bible tells us that you should let your light is so important. You should let your light shine before men, before they can see your good work and glorify your Father in heaven. Your light determines how you view God. Can we say hallelujah? Can we say glory to God? The way you trim your lamb determines how long you how you view Jesus, praise God, and how long you're willing to wait until he come back, praise God. You know he's coming, so you got to keep working. You got to keep watching, praise God. And verse 8, he said, and the foolish said unto the wise, give us of your oil, for our lamp has gone out. It's gone. The foolish had no oil. They only took the oil that was in the lamp. They were not prepared. They only had what they came in with, praise God. They had not prepared themselves, because if you prepared yourself, you have more than what you have in the lamp, praise God. Can we say hallelujah? Can we say glory to God? Can you imagine Jesus coming back and you're not prepared? You're not ready to go with him. Jesus said, watch and pray, because you don't know not what hour I will return. And verse 9 said, but the wise answered and said, not so, praise God, hallelujah. Let there be not enough for us. Let there be not enough for us in you, praise God. But go ye rather to them that sell and buy for yourself. Go your own way, because you heard the same commandment. You heard the same thing that I heard, to be prepared, to be ready. Now go out, praise God, and buy for those who sell, praise God. Verse 10 said, while they went to buy, the bridegroom came, and they were ready. They who were ready went in with him to the marriage. The door was shut, praise God. The door was shut behind, and they that was prepared went into the marriage, praise God, and the door was closed behind them. The bridegroom tarried, but the five wives were prepared. I don't care how long it takes for your blessing to come. Keep working. Keep doing what God told you to do. Keep focused on God, praise God. Not so much the blessing, but keep focused on God. Hallelujah. Because you know if you practice and you focus on God, you're going to be preparing that he's one day coming back. Praise God. The bridegroom tarried, but the five wives was prepared. They was waiting for the set time this morning. Praise God. Verses 11 said, afterward came also the virgin, saying, Lord, Lord, open up. Open to us. Praise God. Hallelujah. But he answered and said, verily I say unto you, I know you're not, praise God, hallelujah. You walk around here partying, you walk around here doing everything, and you're not being prepared. You're not prepared when your blessing comes. You're not prepared when you get ready to come back. You miss your blessing, praise God. The door will be closed. And verse 13, he said, watch, therefore, for ye neither know the day nor the hour within the Son of Man cometh, praise God. Wherein the Son of Man cometh, praise God. You don't know, praise God. You don't know when the set time is coming. God has a set time. God has a set time for your blessing. Don't quit. Don't give up. He's right at your door. He's ready to come in because he has a set time, praise God. Hallelujah. The minute you give up, remember when he started knocking on your door, praise God. Don't quit. Don't give up. Stay focused until you hear him come. Praise God. Hallelujah. See, there are two things that the pressure of the stress that concerning the manifestation of God's promise in the life of the Christian that indicate two things. One is the lack of preparedness. Praise God. There must be a preparedness, God. And also, there's a partial understanding of God's law of spiritual manifestation. Praise God. Hallelujah. In our scripture, Galatians 6:9, he said, let us not be weary in well-doing, for in due season we shall reap if we faint not. Praise God. If you just stay the course. Hallelujah. Lack of preparedness. Praise God. On God's perspective. Praise God. Preparation expedite the manifestation, praise God. When you are ready, praise God. When you have everything lined up, praise God. God is ready to move on your head. The manifestation is set for a appointed time, praise God. But one can miss the divine moment due to lack of preparation, praise God. We gotta be prepared today. Can we say hallelujah? Can we say glory to God? When you focus on the promise instead of preparation, the promise will become a God. It might become an idol to you, praise God, in your life, praise God. Don't focus on the promise. Instead, be prepared. Focus on the preparation. Don't be looking at what the promise is all about. Work on your preparation. Your focus could become an idol, praise God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. 1 Corinthians 10:14 says, wherefore, my dearly beloved, flee from idolatry, praise God. God, see, God told Jacob to return to Bethel in Genesis 35:1. He said, then God said to Jacob, go up to Bethel and settle there and build an altar there to God who appeared to you when you were fleeing from your brother Esau. And verse 2 goes on and says, so Jacob said to his household and to all who was with him, get rid of the folk of the foreign gods you have with you, and purify yourself and change your clothes. And verse 3 says here, he said, then come, let us go up to Bethel, where I will build an altar to God, whose answered me in the day of my distress, and who has been with me wherever I have gone, praise God. When there is a set time, praise God, God gets ready to bless you. He will tell you to remove some things, praise God. Remove some idols, praise God. If you remove your idols and see the face of the promise without preparation, it will be devastating to you, praise God. Because you will be looking at what you are waiting for so long, and now you cannot have exactly because you've been talking about it, you've been crying about it, but you are not ready for it, praise God. You got to be ready for God's blessing this morning. Can we say thank the Lord? Can we say hallelujah, glory to God. Remember this, God gives you a blessing that you are not ready for. The devil will come. The devil will come and take away your blessing, praise God. He will snatch it from you. Hallelujah. Praise God. The second thing, it is the law of spiritual manifestation. One of the ways that God manifests his promise is by giving you the big picture. God gives you the big picture, praise God, so you can understand perfectly what God is saying to you. Can we say hallelujah? When God called Abraham, he gave him the big picture. When we look at Genesis 1, 12, praise God, 1 through 3, he said, the Lord has said to Abraham, leave your country, your people, your father, your household, and go to the land I will show you. Verse 2, I will make you into a great nation, and I will bless you. I will make your name great, and you will be a blessing. Verse 3, I will bless those who bless you, and whoever curses you, I will curse. And all the people on the earth will be blessed through you, praise God. God wants to bless you, increase. He wanted to increase Abraham's knowledge. He wanted to increase Abraham. He showed Abraham the big picture, praise God. God established the timetable, praise God, for the manifestation of the big picture. His timetable looks when Lot departed, praise God. Hallelujah, glory to God. Before you receive your blessing, praise God, from the Lord, you might have to let some things go, praise God. It might even be a friend or a family member, praise God. You got to let it go, and you got to move out, praise God. Hallelujah. God want to bless you, praise God, but sometimes you have things around you that are holding you back, praise God. Let them go. Get rid of it, praise God. Get out of the way. Get out the way of yourself, your feelings sometimes, or get in your way and cause you to miss out on your blessing because you don't have enough inside of you to tell your friend to get back. Get behind me, your relative. Get behind me, praise God. The big picture, praise God. God gave the big picture to Abraham, and then he blessed Abraham when Lot departed, praise God. A lot of Christians are very excited about the big picture, but it don't take time to wait for the where and the when and the how, praise God. In their request for success for themselves instead of God's kingdom, focusing on God's kingdom, the devil hit them with the question when. When, where, and how. When is this thing going to happen, praise God? But they forget that the fullness of God's time, praise God. He has a set time for these things to happen, praise God. So when the devil tell you that when this thing gonna take place, I said, God has a set time for your blessing. And I'm waiting, I'm preparing myself for the blessing, praise God. Hallelujah. Glory to his name. Praise the Lord. The people forgot. They forgot, praise God, that God does not bless you outside of blessing his kingdom, praise God. Everything that God does is about the kingdom work, praise God. You can't change the blessing without forgetting the blesser, praise God. You can't claim the promise and forget the blesser, praise God. Can we say hallelujah? Psalm 102, praise God, 12 said, but thou, O Lord, shall endure forever. And thou rememberest unto all generation, God has been around for a while, my brothers and sisters. He's been around for a while. He will stay around forever, praise God. Every generation will know that Jesus Christ is Lord of lords and King of kings. The Bible says every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. God has a set time here, praise God, hallelujah, glory to his name. Verse 13 said, thou shalt arise and have mercy upon Zion for the time to favor her. Yet the set time is come. He will have mercy, praise God, upon Zion today. Can we say thank the Lord? And so it was. And Hebrew 12 and 2 said, for the joy that was set before him endures the cross, despises the shame, even though that God was being humiliated and all of this. God said he would have joy behind this, praise God. He had joy behind the humiliation, praise God. He died, praise God, to set us free. He died for the nation, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Glory to God. John 11 and 50 said that one man should die for the people, that the whole nation perish not, praise God. There is one man to die. It was necessary for one to die for the nation, praise God. And Jesus Christ died. He died on the cross for the nation. He died on the cross for us. He died on the cross for you, praise God. He died, and he's going to build Zion again when he appears in his glory, praise God, which would be at the second coming, praise God. He died for the nation. He died for me. He died for you. He died that we might have a right this morning, praise God, to the tree of life. He was humiliated, praise God, for the nation and for you, praise God. Our Lord knew that through his sacrifice of death, Zion would ultimately be rebuilt. Jerusalem, the new Jerusalem will be rebuilt at a set time, praise God. God held a set time this morning, praise God, for the building of Jerusalem, praise God. The time is now. Today is your day for salvation this morning, praise God. You can have that salvation this morning, praise God. Today is your day. This is a set time for you this morning, praise God, to give your life to God, praise God. And you can do it just by simply asking Jesus to come into your life. Ask Jesus to come into your life and repent of your sin. Have a contrite spirit, praise God. Hallelujah. And he will come in. He said, I stand at the door and knock. Any man will hear my voice. He would let me come in. I would come in and sit with him. He said, open it up. Open the door. Pray. You can open that door. Just believe, praise God, that Jesus came to this earth. He died. He was God in the flesh. He came here to set us free. It was one person, one man had to die. And he died for you and me, praise God. Hallelujah. And they buried him, praise God. He went to the cross and they buried him in a borrowed tomb, praise God. Hallelujah. 3 days later, God raised him from the dead, praise God, hallelujah. And he now sits on the right hand of the Father, making intercession for you and for me. If you believe that this morning, praise God, there's a set time for you to be saved, and the day is your time, praise God. So let us pray. Father God, I thank you for this word. I thank you for a set time in our life. I thank you, God, for this season. I thank you, God, for what you are doing in life today, God, and that you're blessing us going in and you're blessing us coming out, God. And we know that we celebrate this season because of your son, Jesus, God. And I pray to everyone that are listening this morning, God, that they know they have a set time for God to bless them. They have a set time for his return. And we need to be ready, praise God. Bless those that are in the hospital. Bless all those that we have lost a loved one, praise God. Bless our family, praise God. I'm talking about not only my immediate family, I'm talking about the family of believers, praise God, that are going through this morning, praise God. God, I pray that they know there's a set time for their deliverance, God. And we give you the praise and we give you the glory in Jesus' name, and the body of believers said, amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Glory to the name. If this word has been a blessing to you this morning, praise God, feel free to text us, call us, write us, praise God, and let us know that this word has been a blessing to you, praise God. And if you want to contribute to Kingdom Word Ministry, we can keep going, praise God. Let's text Kingdom Word to 225-25, praise God, and remember, Jesus Christ is Lord.